What happened in cybersecurity in February? Watch this episode of Cybersecurity News to stay up to date. Myanmar's military regime plans to give its telecommunications ministry total control over the country's online services and content. The government will be able to access personal information for security reasons. The bill will be a heavy blow to online freedom in the country. In Florida, hackers tried to poison a water plant supplying 15,000 people. Unidentified hackers managed to remotely access the computer system of Oldsmar's water treatment plant and significantly increase the amount of sodium hydroxide. The leaked Urumqi police database reveals the invasive surveillance techniques aimed at the repressed Uighur Muslim minority. It shows how Chinese authorities collect tons of data and aggressively monitor the group for religious enthusiasm. It seems that Russia is not the only agent to have participated in the SolarWinds hack. Around the same time, Chinese hackers also exploited the company's vulnerabilities. Moreover, two additional organizations, NASA and the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration, have been identified as the victims of the hack. North Korean state-backed hackers have stolen around $300 million in 2020 to fund the country's nuclear and ballistic programs, violating international laws. Facebook imposed restrictions on Australian users and publishers, which stopped them from sharing and viewing Australian and international news media on the platform. As a result, Australians started boycotting the social media giant. Facebook announced the release of its own smartwatch, which will come out sometime in 2022. This raises privacy concerns over the possible abuse of its users' health data and using it for marketing purposes. Researchers found out that Chinese hackers employed a malicious Firefox extension to target vulnerable Tibetan communities. The attacks have been taking place since March 2020. NordVPN. Cybersecurity starts with a click.